In this fine tutorial, we will create an awesome cog icon like that. Then we will take our looping options in After Effects, which we can use to loop icons indefinitely. So it will loop and it will loop and it will loop, and we only need 2 keyframes for it. So you determine the speed which you need, and then it goes on and goes on and goes on. A really cool technique, great to know. So let's head into the tutorial. So we'll prepare this cog icon here. At first, you need to go to your rectangle tool. I'll use the rounded rectangle tool. As I click and hold, select a rounded rectangle. We have a fill, we have no stroke, everything is perfect. Okay, make a rectangle like that in the middle. This is okay, do not worry about the anchor point, do not worry about anything. You can click on the shape layer, and right off the bat, just click add and select repeater. The repeater is repeating the object we have, and we need a few copies of it to not waste any time on making the cog by ourselves. Okay, I know that we need 4 copies. You can also do 5 copies, it's no problem. Please open the transform repeater options, not the transform from the shape layer, the transform from the repeater. And I definitely do not want any position switch, so everything should start here, where the original object starts, and on the rotation, I want 45 degrees. Now I see it should be 4 objects because the 5th object makes it a bit uncomfortable. Okay, and I have the repeated objects perfectly aligned. Now this would be my first part. If you need to change the size of this actual rectangle, that's no problem. You can always go to the rectangle, go to its path, and you can work with the size here. Remember that if you would take it here, it would look ugly because it would resize the entire shape layer. But if you resize this here, you will resize only this object. So you can unlink it, and you can make it longer, you can make it smaller like this, and this would be perfect. Okay, let's say that this is my cog. Okay, the second thing I would like to do would be selecting an ellipse tool. Okay, I'll go closer with the ellipse, I'll start from the middle, and with my shift and control key, I'll make an ellipse like that. Okay, do we have it right? I think it's pretty solid. And now I see that we still would need to move around with this ellipse. Now, this is my mistake because I didn't align everything perfectly to the middle, which I should. If I go to title action save, I should place this object perfectly in the middle. Then looking at this rectangle, I should also position it perfectly in the middle. Now this would make my work easier. Okay, I think I've adjusted it and it still looks a bit dumb. So maybe make this closer. And the ellipse is also a bit big, but I'll not adjust it now. I think we can go from there. Now my very last adjustment would be clicking on this shape layer. You see we are still working on the same shape layer. We have the ellipse, we have the rectangle, and we have our repeater. By having this shape layer selected, click again on your ellipse tool so you don't have to change anything. The only thing you would need to change is selecting to create a mask instead of an object. So I'll come closer with my scroll wheel. I'll again start from the middle, shift key, left control key. Okay, and the size will all depend now. In the mask, I just need to select inverted or just click here, subtract. And the cool thing here is that if I press my selection tool and I double click on this mask, I can resize it like this. Okay, now depending on how you want the, well, it doesn't look like a perfect cog. It looks like a steering wheel from a ship, but that's okay. I think with a few adjustments, it could be a bit better. Maybe this making it closer. And the roundness is too big. Let's make it more cog-like. Okay. Well, closer to it. Now, I want to teach you a cool thing about rotation. I would press R. I would keyframe my rotation. And I would make, maybe in 1 second, like 90 degrees. So this cog would rotate like this. So I do not have to place so many keyframes here. I could select my loop out option. Looping out is a simple expression in After Effects, and you can just select and write here loop out After Effects, and the Helpix Adobe.com website is a big guide to expressions. You don't need to know anything about expressions. I do not know much about them myself, but the loop out option is something that will really, really help you. And as I told, you don't need to know anything, you just copy this loop out. In the type we need cycle, and in the num keyframes, equals 0, this will copy those two keyframes and will loop them. So let me show you. I'll copy this entire reference with my Shift key, Control C, nothing else. I'll go to After Effects. On the rotation, I select my left alt and I click, and I paste that here. Boom, that's it. Look what happens. This expression takes those keyframes and loops them. And the zero at the end tells how many keyframes should be used. Zero is loop the entire animation. One means use this keyframe and the one before the last. Two would say use this keyframe, and the second before the last. I'll show you what I mean by that. You can of course read about this. You should read about this, but for example, loop out cycle one loops the segment bounded by the last keyframe and the second to last keyframe. Let me show you an example. So I have this forward rotation. Let's just add another keyframe to the left side. Now it would go backward, forward, backward, forward, because it would loop the entire animation. But if I do press 1 here, it will loop the last keyframe and the one near to the last. How it's set here, keyframe and the second to last keyframe. Okay, so only those two keyframes would be looped here. So you would have the animation forward, 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 forward. You see, since I wasn't precise here, we have a little stutter here as I play space. Wow, a really crazy animation. My intention was to have a 90 degrees looping option and just loop the icon. On this particular animation, it doesn't matter if you place 0 or 1 here, it will perfectly loop this icon. And this is how you can make seamless icon loops in After Effects. I think that's a awesomely important thing to know about and to know how to use, because if you are working with icon animation and with similar things like that, this will be super helpful. I hope you did enjoy this tutorial. Thank you so much for listening, and see you in the next one.